But let's start away from it all, out on the open road in a car certainly to be enjoyed with Becky Adam.
The AC Cobra blasted its way into the history books almost as quickly as it blasted its way around the track. This wonderful, distinctly bulbous machine was only in production for 6 years. But in that time, it roared past all the competition, left the Corvette standing, and in 1964, swiped the World Sports Car Championship from Ferrari. Brute force was what these cars were all about. The Cobra's history goes back to the early 60s, and the unlikely partnership between AC Cars of Thames Ditton, a quintessentially British car manufacturer, and ex-racing driver Carroll Shelby, an entrepreneurial Texan. He persuaded AC to supply the rolling chassis and Ford the power plant, a big fat 4.7-litre V8. It stayed on, thrashing everything, until new American safety legislation forced most low-volume sports cars off the road. But due to public demand, there's a new factory in deepest Weybridge, and the beast is back. AC is now joint-owned by Ford and Autocraft, who used to make replicas, but today they have exclusive rights on the Cobra name. So, after 20 years, enter the Mark IV.
We produced the car in exactly the same way as AC Cars produced it back in the 60s. We take a 20-foot length of tube out the racks of steel, and we cut it, and we start making a chassis. We fabricate our own wishbones, we fabricate our own discs, uprights, carriers. We fabricate our own body from the flat sheets off the original jigs that AC Cars built all the original Cobras from. The seats and the tonneau covers, the hoods, the trimming is still hand-stitched. We take a, in true traditional form, take a sheet of leather or a skin of leather out of the stores and start cutting up and start trimming the seat. The windscreens, the fuel tanks, the seat frames, the bumper bars are all handmade, right the way through.
Actually buys the car, and what do you think they're looking for?
We're finding the people that are buying the cars now, probably the people that are buying Porsches and other high-performance cars, they're young executives, they're accountants, they're solicitors, they're doctors, they're dentists, they're all the people that seem to earn the money now.
But you'd need 50,000 to spare if you wanted to own a new Mark IV Cobra, and you'll have to hurry because production's being wound down to make way for AC's latest venture, the Ace. Final appearances of this prototype are yet to be decided, but they're planning on using an RS500 engine, but it'll be £800 lighter and four-wheel drive. And they're looking for a 0-60 of 5 seconds, so the future looks good. However, if your heart's still set, like mine, on owning a Cobra, then before you reach for your wallet, you'll have to take a test drive. At least, that's what I told them.
Well, this is an absolute dream come true. This is the Mark IV Cobra, and I'm driving it. It's got a 5-litre V8 engine giving 230 brake horsepower. 0-60 is less than 5 seconds, and 0-100 and back is less than 13. It's environment friendly, runs on unleaded petrol, but I don't know what the Noise Abatement Society would have to say about it. It may be a lot less hairy than its brothers and sisters from the 60s, but this is very definitely a Cobra, and it's very much alive and kicking.
But for some, the only Cobra to have is one from the 60s.
It's an animal to drive. It doesn't have the wonderful road manners, but it's fun. You can put it sideways and be in control. It's lovely noise, lovely powerful, and a beautiful car.
I think it's one of the last of the front-engined, hairy, mean cars, and I don't think anything will ever be reproduced again in this manner. I think it's just one of those lovable things.